Want better, more relevant search results? These are my favorite little-known Google search tips. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and these are the Google search tips you should be using in 2024. First up, you can search for specific file types in Google. Yes, really. So this works by accessing any publicly available files that are floating around on the web. You just type in the name or title or keywords from, say, a report that you need. Then you're gonna hit space and you're gonna type in file type colon. And then if you put PDF, you're going to get PDF search results with that specific keyword you entered as part of the title. So here I have results for pretty general NHL PDFs. Now the same can be done for the other file extensions too. So I don't know, maybe if you wanted an Excel spreadsheet, you would just change the file type to XLS. And now our results are only Excel spreadsheets. Another handy Google search tip is to search between numbers. So say you're looking for a laptop within a certain price range, Google can help you with that. So let's search for laptops between $400 and then we'll add three dots and say $1,400. So now our search results will only be laptops in that price range. It's pretty handy if you're on a budget and you want to immediately exclude more expensive options. The third Google search tip is to use an asterisk when you want Google to fill in the blank for you. So this is a really cool tip if, say, you can't remember the lyrics to a certain song. Using an asterisk in Google search will signal Google to leave that as a placeholder for you that the search engine will need to fill. So using song lyrics as an example, I'm gonna use the quote trick too here, by the way, which I featured in some other Google search videos if you want more info on that. And what's that Taylor song? Take me to the, I'm gonna put asterisk where, and I'll put little quotes. So I'm just gonna hit enter. And would you look at the top search result, lyrics for Taylor Swift's The Lakes. This trick literally works as a fill in the blank for anything you can't remember. So you can see other options too that it's filled in the blank for, like take me to the place and take me to the world. It's pretty neat. The next little known Google search tip is to track your flight. You don't need a third party app, and this is something I've been doing for years. So let's type in the airline code and then the flight number. And this works with or without a space, by the way. And Google's gonna tell you right at the top of the result, real-time flight information, including terminal and gate info, if that's available, whether it's on time or delayed, so the status, the ETA, and more. I use this all the time, love. Now, Google will also pull your local weather for you automatically, but you can also quickly search for the weather for maybe the destination you're going to. So here's how to do both. Simply Google the word weather, and using your location, Google's gonna pull up your local weather, including the 7-day forecast. Now that's pretty awesome, but if you're about to go on a trip, you can simply Google weather, and then put the city in that you're going to. And bam, just like that, now we've got the weather in Cabo, complete with precipitation and wind and a 7-day forecast, and the local time, by the way. Bonus, you can do this with sunrise and sunset too. It works the exact same. So you'd simply type in sunrise or sunset, and that would give you your local sunrise and sunset. If you want it for the destination you're going to, simply add that city after sunset. Another helpful tip is to exclude a word or site from your search result, and this is done with a hyphen. If you want to narrow the search results, you'll type in your search term, and then you're gonna hit space, and then hyphen, and now the word or site you want to exclude. So the band REM minus sleep, because obviously I'm not talking about sleep, I wanna learn about the band REM. And there you go, we've only got results for the band REM. By the way, if you're liking this video so far, remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more content just like this. And with that, we've come to my last Google search tip, and that is to search within a site. That's right, you can do this right from Google. Here's how. So let's say we want to know what TechCrunch has written about Instagram's content filter. We're going to search Instagram content filter, space, then the word site, colon, TechCrunch.com. I'm gonna hit enter, And boom, the only results we've got are TechCrunch articles on Instagram content filters. I've got a bunch of other Google search tips, like searching Google with an image, that and a whole bunch more you can watch here or via the links in the description below. Now, in the meantime, I always recommend, on top of doing any of these tips, you really get familiar with all of the advanced search options. So those are some great Google search tips that every user should know. What are your favorite Google search tips? Let everyone know in the comments below. Remember, I've got more videos on Google search tips and tricks you can watch by clicking here and here, and you can subscribe to my channel by clicking right about here. Thanks for watching. See you next time.